morning. Now we are in the stereoisomer. In previous videos we are completed what is the stereoisomer in that geometrical isomer as well as optical isomer. As all you know very well, what is the meaning of geometrical isomer and what is the meaning of optical isomer. In that optical isomer we are completed very systematically few definitions as well as absolute configuration and relative configuration. That is, absolute configuration means R and S nomenclature, which is given by CIP, Kohn-Ingold and Prelog. That one is called as CIP system. Now, what happened in previous videos? We are completed stereoisomers very systematically. In that stereoisomers, you know very well what is the meaning of optical activity. Tumhala डबल सांगण्याची गरज नाही. द प्लेन ऑफ प्लेन पोलराइज्ड लाईट आर पासिंग थ्रू सर्टन ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड, देन दॅट कंपाऊंड हॅव अ टेंडन्सी टू रोटेट दॅट लाईट आयदर क्लॉक वाईज ऑर अँटी क्लॉक वाईज डायरेक्शन, देन सच फेनॉमिनॉन इज कॉल्ड एज ऑप्टिकल ऍक्टिव्हिटी. अँड दोज कंपाऊंड विच हॅव सच टेंडन्सी, देन दॅट कंपाऊंड इज कॉल्ड एज द ऑप्टिकली ऍक्टिव्ह कंपाऊंड. यू नो व्हेरी वेल वॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ ऑप्टिकल ऍक्टिव्हिटी. आफ्टर द ऑप्टिकल ऍक्टिव्हिटी we are completed very systematically one and very important definition related with it. That definition is called as the enantiomers. What is the meaning of enantiomers? Enantiomers are the optical isomer which have a non-superimposable mirror images on each other, and those compound which have non-superimposable mirror images on each other, then such compound is also called as the enantiomers. And enantiomers are the optical isomer which is also called as antipodes. Tumhala puna double sangnyachi garaj nahi. What is the meaning of enantiomers? After the enantiomers, we are also completed next and very important phenomena, diastereomers. What is the meaning of diastereomers? The diastereomers means the two compound which does not have a mirror images on each other, but they have a same molecular formula as well as a structural formula. The diastereomers also we are completed very systematically. Then after that diastereomers, we are completed the next compound. That compound is called like the meso compound. What is the meaning of meso compounds? As all you know, meso compounds are the compounds which are optically inactive because they have plane of symmetry, and those compound which have a plane of symmetry, then such compound is called as the meso compound. And meso compound is optically inactive. Why this is optically inactive? Due to internal compensation. Internal compensation means self compensation of that light takes place, then such compound is called as the meso compound. Because these are the very systematic and preliminary definitions required to you by considering the stereochemistry. याच्यानंतर टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग विथ यू व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक, दॅट वन इज कॉल्ड लाय द वॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ रेसिमिक मिक्सचर. वन्स यू नो रेसिमिक मिक्सचर, द रिमेनिंग पार्ट बिकम व्हेरी सिम्पल. अँड आफ्टर दॅट रेसिमिक मिक्सचर यू मस्ट नो वॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ रिझोल्यूशन. वॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ रिझोल्यूशन? दीज टू टर्म्स इज इम्पॉर्टंट बाय कन्सिडरिंग द स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री. नाव बिफोर गोइंग टू रेसिमिक मिक्सचर, आय विल गिव यू सम एक्झाम्पल रिलेटेड विथ द आर अँड एस नॉमेनक्लेचर विच वी आर already discussed in the previous video. What is R? R stand for rectus and S stand for sinister. As all you know very well, in Fischer projection formula, if lowest priority group present on the horizontal line, then the configuration is reverse, and if lowest priority group present on the vertical line, then as it is configuration you write down for that particular molecule. Now what is the meaning of resolution? I will give you some definition, then later on we'll going to discussing some example. Suppose for example we have this type of molecule. Suppose for example we have this type of molecule. Suppose here CHO, then finally we are considering suppose here OH, suppose here H, and suppose here CH3. This one of the molecule, and this star carbon is called as the chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. As all you know, why this star carbon is asymmetric carbon? Because this attached to the four different groups, right? Now tell me, what is the configuration of this molecule, whether this molecule is R or S, whether this molecule is R or S? You know, this is a first priority, this is a second priority, and this is a third priority. So this is the priority sequence, and lowest priority group is on the horizontal line. The rotation of this molecule, first to second, then third, you know very well this is anti-clockwise, but hydrogen present on horizontal, therefore it is called as the R. You know very well this already. Now my question is this: when we see the mirror image of this molecule, when we see the mirror image of this molecule, you know the mirror image of this molecule is non-superimposable. Why mirror image of this molecule is non-superimposable? If we see the mirror image of this molecule, then mirror image of this molecule is like this. Here OH, here H, and finally here CH3. Now what is the configuration of this? This is the first priority group, this is the second priority group, and this is the third priority group, but hydrogen present on horizontal line. Then what about the rotation, first, second, third? The rotation is clockwise, but hydrogen horizontal, therefore this is yes. Now, by considering all this phenomenon, you know very well these two are the enantiomers. Why these two are the enantiomers? Because these are the optical isomer which have a non-superimposable mirror images on each other. So these are the enantiomers. Now, what is the meaning of racemic mixture? Listen, dear student, this is very important. What is the meaning of racemic mixture? If we mix these two enantiomers, that is called as equimolar mixture of enantiomer, equimolar mixture. Now, you mix these two compound. Suppose equimolar means what? Suppose this is 50% and this one is also 50%, and mixture of enantiomer, you got it? Mixture of enantiomer is called as racemic mixture. Is it okay? So what is the meaning of racemic mixture? The equimolar mixture of enantiomer, is called as the racemic mixture. After mixing of these two enantiomer, that mixture is called as racemic mixture. And actually, racemic mixture is optically inactive. Why? Because in this mixture, we have this isomer and this isomer. Barabar hai. He doni isomer tumhala mixture madhe astil. Mag balanno, jar tumhi ikadna PPL pass kela. PPL means what? Plane polarized light. Ha molecule kay karnar? त्या पीपीएलला क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करणार, ऑब्विसली, बिकॉज रोटेशन इज क्लॉकवाइज आर. आणि मग तीच लाईट इकडे जाणार ना, क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट झालेली लाईट या मॉलेक्युलमध्ये जाणार. मग हा मॉलेक्युल इक्वल अँगलनी त्याला अँटी क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करणार. म्हणजे याचा अर्थ काय झाला? तुम्ही जी लाईट पास केली, ती लाईट जशाला तशी बाहेर निघाली ना, देर इज नो ऑप्टिकल रोटेशन. इफ देर इज नो ऑप्टिकल रोटेशन, देन व्हाट वी से दॅट दिस मिक्सर इज ऑप्टिकली इनॅक्टिव्ह ना. ऑप्टिकल ॲक्टिव्हिटी येण्यासाठी काहीतरी रोटेशन असलं पाहिजे. विदाउट रोटेशन वी कॅन नॉट डिस्कस द ऑप्टिकल ॲक्टिव्हिटी. इट मीन्स दॅट देर इज नो नेट रोटेशन इन साईड ऑफ दिस मिक्सर, देअरफॉर दिस मिक्सर इज ऑप्टिकली इनॲक्टिव्ह. अँड इफ समवन आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन लाईक दिस, वाय रेसिमिक मिक्सर इज ऑप्टिकली इनॅक्टिव्ह, देन युअर परफेक्ट आन्सर इज ड्यू टू एक्स्टर्नल कंपन्सेशन. अँड वाय मिझो कंपाऊंड इज ऑप्टिकली इनॅक्टिव्ह? ड्यू टू इंटरनल कंपन्सेशन. देअरफॉर दिस इज द व्हेरी मच इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग्स, राईट डाऊन इन युअर नोटबुक. द रेसिमिक मिक्सर इज ऑप्टिकली इनॅक्टिव्ह ड्यू टू एक्स्टर्नल कंपन्सेशन. राईट डाऊन सेकंड हायलाईट नोट, मिझो कंपाऊंड इज ऑप्टिकली इनॅक्टिव्ह ड्यू टू इंटरनल कंपन्सेशन. सो दीज आर द रेसिमिक मिक्सर. नाऊ व्हॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ रिझोल्युशन? दिस इज अ व्हेरी सिम्पल टर्म. रिझोल्युशन मीन्स व्हॉट? नाव वी हॅव अ रेसिमिक मिक्सर. Now you separate that racemic mixture into two isomers. The separation of racemic mixture into two enantiomer is called as the resolution. Lakshat tumcha manje racemic mixture madhe je don isomer ahet, jeva tumhi tela separate karta, the separation have a different method, either maybe physical method or chemical method, but separation is very important. And separation of racemic mixture into two enantiomer is called as the resolution. So these are the very basic terms required to you in the stereochemistry. What is the meaning of optical activity? You know. What is the meaning of enantiomers? You know. What is the meaning of diastereomers? You know. What is the meaning of meso compound? You know. What is the meaning of racemic mixture? You know. What is the meaning of resolution? You know. All these things you know very well. Now we are going to discussing some example related with the stereochemistry. You read all this definition, and the problem related with the stereochemistry, the problem is generally on the basis of RNS nomenclature system. In Fischer projection formula, how to decide whether the given configuration is R, or how to decide whether the given configuration is S, this is very important to you. Now, today I am going to discussing with you some example related with this, So, which are the examples here? Suppose I ask you the question, which molecule is chiral and which molecule is achiral, or which molecule is optically active or which molecule is optically inactive? See, they ask you the question. What type of question they ask you in examination? This is very important, you know. If you know all this concept, if you are unable to solve the MCQ question, then the doesn't use of that your study. So you selectively select the correct answer from that question. And how you select the correct answer? See toward the board. Suppose I have this type of molecule COOH. Suppose here also COOH. And if I am putting here OH and here OH, and suppose here OH and here OH. Now my question is this, whether this molecule is optically active or not, whether this molecule contain the chiral carbon or not. Yes, obviously, this one is the chiral carbon and this one is the chiral carbon. This attached to OH, COOH, H and this bulky group. And this attached to OH, COOH, H and this bulky group. Therefore, these two carbon is chiral carbon. Now, if we consider the mirror image of this molecule, if we consider the mirror image of this molecule, then what about the mirror image of this molecule? Suppose we have here one COOH, suppose you have here another COOH, and for example here H and here OH, and suppose for example, sorry, here OH, because this is mirror image, here OH and here H, and here also OH and here H, this is a mirror image of this. Suppose for example, if you consider the mirror image is non-superimposable, no, your answer is wrong, these two are identical. Why these two are identical? Because this molecule is not chiral, na. This molecule is achiral, this molecule is achiral, this molecule is optically inactive. Tell me why this molecule is optically inactive? Because this molecule have a plane of symmetry, this molecule have a plane of symmetry, therefore this compound is meso compound and meso compound is optically inactive. And if we consider the mirror image of meso compound, the both are same because it doesn't have optical activity, na. When both are same, therefore these two are identical. Your answer is what? They ask you the question. What is the relation between these two? Whether these two are enantiomers, whether these two are diastereomers, whether these two are any other compound, or these two are identical, then your answer is these two are the identical because these are the meso compound, this doesn't have mirror image. If I ask you the another question to you, suppose for example, see toward this, another question is like this. Suppose I have this type of molecule, COOH, and suppose for example, here another COOH. If we consider here OH and here H and here OH, and if we taking the mirror image of this molecule, if we mirror image of this molecule, now what about the mirror image of this molecule? COOH, here also what? COOH, and if we consider here OH and here H, suppose here H and this is OH, this is the mirror image of this molecule. Now, if anyone asks you the question, what is the relation between these two? Then your answer is now enantiomer. Why this is enantiomer? Because this is not a meso compound, na. This is chiral molecule. This is chiral molecule, but this is a chiral molecule. This is optically inactive, but this molecule is optically active. We can calculate the optical rotation of this molecule. How? You know very well. Suppose numbering start from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Also 1, 2, 3, 4. Now my question is this: second carbon is the chiral carbon? Yes or no? What is the configuration of this molecule on second carbon? You know very well, on second carbon, first priority go to the OH because atomic number of O is greater than CCH. Therefore, first priority goes to the OH. The second priority goes to either bulky group or COOH. Dear student, second priority goes to COOH. Why COOH? If we write the structure of COOH, the structure of COOH is like this, na. Now, C double bond O means two, one phantom atom is there. It means carbon attached to three oxygen. Two oxygen here and one oxygen here, but this carbon attached to one oxygen, one carbon and one hydrogen, but this carbon attached to three oxygen atom. Therefore, second priority goes to the COOH and then third priority goes to the bulky group. You don't be confused, huh? Second priority goes to the COOH, don't go toward the bulky group. This is very important to you. Then what about the rotation? First to second, then second to third. Then rotation is anti-clockwise, but hydrogen is on the horizontal, therefore this is 2R. Yes or no? The configuration of this molecule is 2R. Now come toward this. Now in this case, what about the third chiral carbon? The first priority goes to the OH. Obviously, first priority goes to the OH. Then second priority goes to the COOH, na, because this carbon attached to 1O, 1H and 1C. But this carbon attached to 3O like this, second priority goes to bulky COOH. And now third priority goes to the bulky group. Rotation first, second, third. What about this rotation? This rotation is also anti-clockwise, but hydrogen is on horizontal. Therefore, configuration of this molecule is 2R, 3R. And if we consider, you calculate the configuration of this molecule yourself, you decide the configuration of this molecule yourself, the configuration become 2S, 3S. Therefore, these two are the enantiomer of each other. So this is very important things related to you. You see, if any molecule have a plane of symmetry, then such compound is called as the meso compound, and meso compound is optically inactive. Why meso compound is optically inactive? Due to internal compensation, and equimolar mixture of enantiomer is called as the racemic mixture, if they ask you the question. And what is the important racemic mixture we are denoted by, suppose we have tartaric acid, tartaric acid is optically active. Listen dear student, this is very important. Suppose we have tartaric acid, if we write plus tartaric acid, then this tartaric acid is optically active. If we write simply minus tartaric acid, it means levo rotatory tartaric acid. But if we write plus minus tartaric acid, this is racemic mixture. Why this is racemic mixture? Because this is the equimolar mixture of plus and minus. You got it? This is equimolar mixture of enantiomer. Sometime in place of plus minus, they write like this is DL, DL. It means one enantiomer have a dextro rotation and another enantiomer have a levo rotation. So this is the representation of racemic mixture, either plus minus or a DL. You know what is resolution? The separation of racemic mixture into two enantiomer, that one is called as the resolution. So these are the very much important concept related to you. Now I will give you some another example related to this R and S nomenclature system, because once if you know all these example, then this part become very simple to you. This part become the very simple to you. Suppose see, we are going to discussing the next example related with this R and S nomenclature system, which are the next example seat on the board. I will give you all example and calculate yourself what is the configuration of this molecule, whether the given compound is R, whether the given compound is S. Suppose I have this type of molecule, here NH2, suppose here OH, suppose here H, and here CH3. This is example number one. Tell me yourself. Suppose example number two, suppose we have this type of molecule COOH, suppose this is CHO, suppose this is NH2, suppose this is H, this is another second molecule. Now this is a third molecule, suppose we have a third molecule, and if we consider here CH2Cl, if we consider here CH2OH, if we consider here CH2, and finally here CH3, this is the third example. Now what about the fourth example? Suppose we have here CN, and suppose here we have a CH2NH2, and suppose we have here OH, and suppose we have here H. Now tell me what is the configuration of this molecule. This is a molecule which contains only one chiral carbon atom. This is very important things. Now In this case, tell me first priority goes to what? First priority goes to the OH, because atomic number of O is greater than N. The second priority goes to the N, and third priority goes to the CH3, and fourth priority goes to the hydrogen atom. Now these are the priority sequence. What about rotation? First, second, third. Now rotation is clockwise. You see, but lowest priority is on the vertical, na? If lowest priority group is on the vertical line, then there is no need to change the configuration. Tumhala कॉन्फिग्रेशन बदलायची गरज नाही. मग जे क्लॉकवाइज असेल, मग क्लॉकवाइज मीन्स रेक्टस, रेक्टस स्टँड फॉर दी आर. देअरफॉर द कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस मॉलेक्युल इज आर. ॲज पर माय आयडिया, ॲज पर माय ओपिनियन, तुमच्या ते लक्षात येत असावं. आणि लक्षात तुमच्या याच्यानंतर बघा आता व्हॉट इज द सेकंड इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग. सपोज वी हॅव दिस टाईप ऑफ मॉलेक्युल. नाव इन दिस केस फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी गोष्ट टेल मी NH2. वाय फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी गोष्ट NH2? बिकॉज ॲटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ नायट्रोजन इज ग्रेटर दॅन कार्बन, ना? दिस अटॅच टू कार्बन, दिस अटॅच टू कार्बन, बट दिस अटॅच टू नायट्रोजन. ॲटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ नायट्रोजन इज ग्रेटर दॅन कार्बन. आफ्टर NH2 आयदर COOH ऑर CHO, COOH, बिकॉज दिस कार्बन अटॅच टू 3 ऑक्सिजन अँड दिस कार्बन अटॅच टू 2 ऑक्सिजन. आउट ऑफ 2 वन इज फॅन्टॉम ॲटम, दिस आउट ऑफ 3 ओनली वन इज अ फॅन्टॉम ॲटम. देअरफॉर द सेकंड प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द COOH, अँड थर्ड प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द CHO, and fourth priority goes to the hydrogen, but fourth priority group is on the horizontal line. Therefore, what about rotation? First, second, third, then the rotation is what? Clockwise. Rotation is clockwise, but this is on horizontal. Therefore, the reverse the configuration, and then the configuration of this molecule is S. S or no? Configuration of this molecule is what? Yes. So this is very interesting and very important things. Now, dear student, what about this molecule? What about this third case? This is CH2Cl, CH2OH, and this is CH2CH2. But C attached to Cl, C attached to O. Atomic number of Cl is greater than O, na? Because you know third sequence rule or third priority sequence rule. If first atom cannot decide the priority, then priority sequence depends upon the second atom. If second atom cannot decide, then third atom. So this is the third rule required to you in the RS nomenclature. Now my dear student, both are the carbon, but this carbon attached to Cl, but this carbon attached to OH. So Cl, atomic number of Cl is greater than OH, therefore the first priority goes to the CH2Cl, and second priority goes to what? CH2OH. Third priority goes to the CH3 and fourth priority goes to the hydrogen. Then what about the rotation of this molecule? First, second, third. The rotation is what? Clockwise. But hydrogen is on vertical, therefore the configuration is as it is. The configuration is what? R. म्हणजे मला वाटत नाही तुम्हाला याच्यात काही डाऊट येईल, बिकॉज दिस इज अ व्हेरी सिंपल थिंग्स, व्हेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स रिलेटेड विथ दिस फेनॉमेनॉन. नाउ व्हाट अबाउट दिस केस? टेल मी व्हाट अबाउट दिस केस. नाउ फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी गोज टू, येस टेल मी युअर सेल्फ, द फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द OH, बिकॉज ॲटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ O इज ग्रेटर दॅन दिस C. आफ्टर द OH, आयदर CH2NH2 ऑर CN. यू नो CN इज अ फंक्शनल ग्रुप इन विच कार्बन अटॅच टू नायट्रोजन व्हाया ट्रिपल बॉन्ड. मग मला सांगा, सी आणि एन मध्ये जर ट्रिपल बॉन्ड असेल तर एन हा थ्री टाइम आहे ना. आउट ऑफ दॅट थ्री टाइम टू इज द फॅन्टॉम ॲटम. टू इज द व्हॉट? फॅन्टॉम ॲटम. मग मला सांगा, दोन जर फॅन्टॉम असतील तर सी एन मध्ये मग सेकंड प्रायोरिटी कोणाला जाईल? तुमची सी एन ला. देन व्हॉट अबाउट द थर्ड प्रायोरिटी? CH2NH2. व्हॉट अबाउट द फोर्थ प्रायोरिटी? दिस हायड्रोजन. ना फर्स्ट, सेकंड, थर्ड रोटेशन इज व्हॉट? क्लॉक वाईज. बट हायड्रोजन इज ऑन हॉरिझॉन्टल, देर द कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज येस. सो म्हणजे मला 100% गॅरंटी आहे. आता कुठलंही जरी तुम्हाला फिशर प्रोजेक्शन दिलं अँड इफ दे आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन, डिसाइड द कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस मॉलेक्युल, ते तुम्हाला सहज एका मिनटाच्या आत येऊन जाईल, काही प्रॉब्लेम येणार नाही. आता हे झालं वन कायरल कंटेनिंग मॉलेक्युल. नाव वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग द नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल, दॅट वन इज कॉल्ड द टू कायरल कंटेनिंग मॉलेक्युल. वॉट हॅपन इन दिस टू कायरल कंटेनिंग मॉलेक्युल? सपोज वी हॅव दिस टाईप ऑफ मॉलेक्युल. सपोज हियर COOH, हियर CHO, हियर OH, हियर H अँड हियर OH, हियर H. माय क्वेश्चन इज दिस, दिस कंपाऊंड इज मिझो कंपाऊंड? नो, दिस इज नॉट मिझो कंपाऊंड. वाय? इफ वी पासिंग द प्लेन हियर, तुम्हाला वाटतं हे दोन सेम आहेत, हे दोन सेम आहेत, पण वर COOH आहे आणि खाली CHO आहे. ईच अँड एव्हरीथिंग यू मस्ट बी सी व्हेरी सिरियसली, बिकॉज वी कांट से वट टाईप ऑफ क्वेश्चन दे आस्क इन द एक्झामिनेशन. सो बाय कन्सिडरिंग द frequency of that question, you check very systematically whether the given compound is meso compound or not. And tumhala mahit hai which are the important aspects required to identify whether the given compound is meso or not. So this is not meso compound, manun yacha tumhala kadta yeil. Now my another question, numbering start from COOH, he pan mahatvacha aahe. Tumhi itna numbering suru kelte ha second hoil, mag second cha configuration vegla yeil, mag tumcha uttar chukun jail. Numbering in this molecule is strictly on the basis of IUPAC. That rules required to decide the numbering you know very well, because IUPAC nomenclature topic is already completed. So see, 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. So this is a numbering in this nomenclature, in this molecule. Now what is the configuration of second carbon? What is the configuration of second carbon? Tell me, in second carbon, the first priority goes to the OH, you know second priority goes to the COOH, because in previous example we are already discussed this, second priority goes to the COOH and third priority goes to the bulky group. Now dear student, rotation is first second, then rotation is what? Anticlockwise. Hydrogen horizontal, anticlockwise horizontal, therefore the configuration of this molecule is 2R, yes or no? Then what about this? Suppose for example we are going toward the third molecule. Now first priority goes to the OH, but second priority goes to CHO. Why? In CHO, CHO means aldehyde, C double bond OH. We write like this way, COOH, we have two O attached to carbon, na? But this carbon attached only one O, another C, therefore second priority goes to CHO, third priority goes to the bulky group, therefore the configuration is first, second, third, once again clockwise, therefore the molecule is 3R, hydrogen is on the horizontal. So this is the molecule which you consider. Now I'm going to discussing with you the another example in which we represent this molecule by three dimension way. Suppose we have this molecule. If I am putting here iodine, suppose iodine, then after that here BR, what is the meaning of BR? Here BR, what is the meaning of this thick line? Thick line indicate above the plane, yes or no? Above the plane. Suppose I am putting here F. Why I am putting here F by dotted line? F by dotted line means F below the plane, yes or no? This is in front of the plane, this is behind the plane or below the plane, yes? And after that, suppose we write here CL. Now, this is the molecule which we represent by using the flying wedge formula. This formula is called as the flying wedge formula. Listen very carefully, which are the important aspects related in this flying wedge formula. Now in this flying wedge formula, the first priority goes to the iodine, second priority goes to the BR, and third priority goes to the CL, and the fourth priority goes to the F. So you first identify, you first check whether the fourth priority group, whether the fourth priority group is on, is in front of the plane or behind the plane. इथं मात्र तुम्ही चुकू नका, इथं चुकलात की मग तुमचा आन्सर चुकून जाईल. यू डोंट बी कन्फ्यूज हियर. आता मला सांगा, हा जो चौथा प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप दिसतो तुम्हाला, लास्ट प्रायोरिटी, दिस रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय डॉटेड लाईन, इट मीन्स इट इज अ बिहाइंड द प्लेन, इट मीन्स अवे फ्रॉम ऑब्झर्वर. म्हणजे हा डॉटेडला दिसला की समजून घ्यायचं तो व्हर्टिकलला आहे, आणि इफ इट इज ऑन व्हर्टिकल देन नो नीड टू चेंज द कॉन्फिग्रेशन. ना जे कॉन्फिग्रेशन असेल तुम्हाला तेच लिहावं लागेल. आणि जर समजा चुकून हा इथं गेला असता आणि हा जर इथं आला असता, म्हणजे समजा बी आरचा जागी एफ गेला आणि एफच्या जागी बी आर आला, देन कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस मॉलिक्यूल बिकम रिव्हर्स. आय विल गिव यू दॅट एक्झाम्पल ऑल्सो, मी तुम्हाला ते पण एक्झाम्पल देईल. आता मला सांगा, व्हॉट इज द कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस, याचं कॉन्फिग्रेशन काय असेल? याचं कॉन्फिग्रेशन असेल आयच्या नंतर बी आर, आयच्या नंतर बी आर बिकॉज सेकंड प्रायोरिटी, आणि बी आरच्या नंतर सी एल, रोटेशन इज क्लॉक वाईज, देअरफॉर द कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज आर. 1% विचार करायचा नाही. का तर वाय इट इज आर? बिकॉज लोएस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप हा बिहाइंड द प्लेन आहे. दिस इज कॉल्ड अवे फ्रॉम ऑब्झर्वर, दिस इज द अवे फ्रॉम ऑब्झर्वर. अँड इफ द लोएस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप इज अवे फ्रॉम ऑब्झर्वर, देन देर इज नो नीड टू चेंज द कॉन्फिग्रेशन. आलं लक्षात तुमच्या? आता हीच केस जर तुम्हाला मी म्हणलं, हीच केस जर तुम्हाला मी असं लिहिली, सपोज आय हॅव दिस मॉलिक्युल, आणि मी जर काय केलं, समजा इथं आय घेतलं आणि इथं काय केलं मी, सपोज फॉर एक्झाम्पल इथं मी तुमचा एफ घेतला, इथं मी तुमचा एफ घेतला, आणि सपोज आय हॅव सपोज हियर बी आर, आय हॅव सपोज हियर बी आर अँड हियर सी एल. बळांनो रोटेशन काय येईल तुमचं? रोटेशन येईल तुमचं क्लॉक वाईजच. पण एफ हा तुमचा थिक लाईनला आहे ना, एफ हा तुमचा इन फ्रंट ऑफ द प्लेन आहे. व्हॉट इंडिकेट इन फ्रंट ऑफ द प्लेन? दॅट इज टुवर्ड्स ऑब्झर्वर, तो ऑब्झर्वरच्या डायरेक्शनला आहे. इट मीन्स दॅट इज ऑन द हॉरिझॉन्टल प्लेन. आणि इफ इट इज ऑन द हॉरिझॉन्टल प्लेन देन यू रिव्हर्स द कॉन्फिग्रेशन. मग हा जो दिसतोय तुम्हाला, रोटेशन इज क्लॉक वाईज, बट ड्यू टू इन फ्रंट ऑफ द प्लेन, ड्यू टू अबोव द प्लेन, एफ इज लोएस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप इज ऑन अबोव द प्लेन. मग हा जर दिसतो त्याच्या उलटा असते ते, म्हणून रोटेशन इज क्लॉक वाईज बट कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज व्हॉट? येस, रोटेशन इज क्लॉक वाईज बट कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज येस. समटाईम दे रिप्रेझेंट दिस मॉलिक्यूल लाईक दिस वे इन फ्लाइंग वेज फॉर्म्युला, इन थ्री डी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लाइंग वेज फॉर्म्युला, दे आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन लाईक दिस. मग अशा वेळेस तुम्ही काय करायचं? जस्ट यू सी वेदर द लोएस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप इज अबोव द प्लेन और वेदर द लोएस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप इज बिलो द प्लेन. आलं लक्षात तुमच्या? इफ इट इज अबोव द प्लेन देन रिव्हर्स द कॉन्फिग्रेशन, अँड इफ इट इज बिलो द प्लेन देन नो नीड टू रिव्हर्स द कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस मॉलिक्यूल. सो दीज आर द एक्झाम्पल रिलेटेड विथ दिस. सपोज फॉर एक्झाम्पल आता मी तुम्हाला आणखी काही एक्झाम्पल घेतो. समजा माझ्याकडे हा कार्बन आहे, सपोज दिस इज कार्बन, दिस अटॅच टू ओ एच, दिस अटॅच टू ओ एच, दिस इज सम एक्झाम्पल रिलेटेड विथ दिस. दिस इज द सी ओ ओ एच, दिस इज द सी ओ ओ एच, अँड सपोज वी हॅव दिस इज द सी एच थ्री, दिस इज द सी एस थ्री. व्हॉट इंडिकेट सी एस थ्री? सी एस थ्री इंडिकेट अबोव द प्लेन अँड दिस इज द एच, अँड एच मीन्स व्हॉट? बिलो द प्लेन. फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द ओ एच, एस ऑर नो? द सेकंड प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द सी ओ ओ एच अँड थर्ड प्रायोरिटी गोज टू द सी एस थ्री. रोटेशन इज व्हॉट? फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड क्लॉक वाईज. बट हायड्रोजन इज ऑन द, हायड्रोजन कुठं आहे तुमचा? बिलो द प्लेन आहे. मग हायड्रोजन बिलो द प्लेन असेल तर उलटं करण्याची गरज आहे का? नो नीड टू रिव्हर्स द कॉन्फिग्रेशन, देअरफॉर द कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ दिस मॉलिक्यूल इज आर. म्हणजे ॲज पर माय आयडिया हाऊ टू कॅल्क्युलेट द आर अँड एस नॉमेनक्लेचर सिस्टम हे तुमच्या लक्षात येईल. नो नीड टू एक्सप्लेन अगेन मोर एक्झाम्पल बिकॉज हाऊ टू कॅल्क्युलेट यू डू प्रॅक्टिस फ्रॉम बुक. तुम्ही भरपूर पुस्तकं वाचा, इतके पुस्तकं वाचा की तुम्हाला त्या प्रत्येक पुस्तकामध्ये जे जे एक्झाम्पल येतील ते तुम्हाला येऊन जातील. आणि जर एखादं एक्झाम्पल येत नसेल तर तुम्ही आम्हाला विचारा. आता मी हे तुम्हाला जनरल आयडिया दिली हे सगळ्या गोष्टीची, स्टिरिओ ॲसोमरमध्ये ऑप्टिकल ॲक्टिव्हिटी, इनॅन्शोमर्स, डायस्टिरिओमर्स, मिझो कंपाऊंड, रेसिमिक मिक्सर, रिझोल्युशन, व्हॉट इज आर अँड एस नॉमेनक्लेचर. आता आपण नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओमध्ये काय करू, मी तुम्हाला असे फॉर्म्युले देतो की तुम्हाला एका मिनटाच्या आत तुम्हाला एखाद्या मॉलेक्युलचं किती ॲसोमर येतात का, तर माईट मे बी हॅपन इन एक्झामिनेशन. दे आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन, टोटल नंबर ऑफ ॲसोमर गिवन बाय दिस मॉलेक्युल. नाव टोटल नंबर मीन्स व्हॉट? माईट मे बी हॅपन दॅट मॉलेक्युल शो स्ट्रक्चरल ॲसोमर ॲज वेल ॲज स्टिरिओ ॲसोमर. सो ॲडिशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल प्लस स्टिरिओ, दॅट इज टोटल नंबर. बट इन स्टिरिओ हाऊ मेनी ॲसोमर आज ऑप्टेनड, दॅट वी विल डिस्कसिंग इन द नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.